Okay, so this video tutorial is going to be for exercise 3. Here in the PDF file, if you look at it, and you read the instructions, the first set of standout dimensions are going to be that this room is going to be 30 feet by 40 feet, and it's going to be 20 feet tall. So let's go over to our SketchUp. We're going to have to erase our good friend there. And you can use rectangle option, and let's just click on the origin. And I'm going to type in 40 feet, comma, space, 30 feet, enter. Okay, so there's our footprint. Let's make this 20 feet tall. Click, type in 20 feet. Okay. Now I'm just going to adjust this. And we're going to erase the stuff that we don't need, which are these three lines here. Let's see if we do it in one hit. Nope, didn't do it. Sometimes you can get it in one shot. Okay, so if you go over to our instructions, they've already got some texture on the floor there, and they've got the walls that are yellow. So let's do that. Let's go paint can. And let me click on that. It'll give us our different options. Let's go color, and I'm going to go with yellow just like the example. You don't have to. Let's collapse that menu, and let's go carpet. Put some nice carpeting on there. Beautiful. Now let's create our pool. Okay. We're using the rectangle option to do that. We're now going to go over to the push-pull, and we're going to grab this option, which is the offset. Do that. Just click once. Bring it in. Looks good there. We're now going to go back to that option, and we're going to select our push-pull. Let's push-pull that up. And let's push-pull this up, like so. This is going to be our water. So let's go with some concrete for the pool. Okay. Let's scroll down and let's grab some water. I'm going to assume that you're going to want some nice clean water in your pool. Okay, so we've got our pool. Next up is you're going to have to make some stairs to get into this pool. If you don't include stairs, you will lose marks. One mark, in fact. Okay. Use the rectangle. Go midpoint to midpoint. Let's pull this out with our push-pull option. And we now have some stairs. Perfect. We're going to use our orbit, and we're going to swing this over. And let's zoom in here. We're now going to create our first step. Okay, we're going to do it on the wall. We're going to start just a little bit off the floor. Do not, I repeat, do not start on the floor. If you do, it's going to be problematic in later steps. Okay, so let's go and adjust this so we can put a window around it to make it into a component. Like so. Let's right click, make component. I'm going to go with component 1. Okay, let's just move this over slightly. Let's change the color of that step. Keep in mind to do so, we're going to have to edit the component. Okay, got to do that in edit component mode. Okay, so also we're going to edit component. We're going to push and pull that out, like so. Perfect. Okay, now we've got our first step. And we might be getting a little bit ahead of ourselves. What you want to do now is you want to take your pencil, and we're going to create our second floor. You're going to need that to join the steps to it. And our second floor should not go past the pool. So let's stop at about here. Let's go rectangle option, start there, and let's end there. So now that we've got that floor, Let's kind of zoom in here. Now what you're going to do is you're going to hold the control key down. You're going to use the move option and click on that inside corner. Go up to there on edge. Let's go /7, enter. Okay, perfect. Now you might end up with more stairs than you need. Like if these stairs overlap each other, you might have to go back down to the undo it, and use a smaller number. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to edit this component once again. And we're going to go and use our circle. We're going to create a circle right there. And now let's use our start from the center, please. Okay, let's go up. This is going to be the beginning of our railing. See how all the other ones got the change. Join this one. Do not bring this all the way to the top. Now what you want to do is you want to go down here and you're going to select this option here. This is follow me. And we're going to go into the circle, click once, follow the railing up to the first one, click, and you now have your thickness. Okay, so we can get out of the edit component mode and we have our staircase, we have our railing. Now we need a way to get our people actually upstairs through that floor. So let's pick our rectangle option and let's make ourselves a nice rectangle like so. And let's right click and erase that so people can actually make their way up to that second floor. Okay, so let's make our diving board. Okay, so we're gonna go, let's make a diving board. And we'll go over here and we're gonna push pull that up. Click, and we're going to go halfway point, and let's pull this out like so, click, looks good, you should be able to make your way into the pool. Okay, now we're going to make the railing for the second floor. To do so, let's just make ourselves a circle, like so. And we're going to make ourselves a line just like the other one. Go straight. Okay, so now the best way I find to make something a component usually is that window option. So you might have to orientate this. And let's right click, make components. Okay. Now let's zoom out, and okay. Now we're gonna copy this all the way across. So I'm gonna hold the control down, I'm gonna pick this up, and I'm gonna move this over. Now, see how all your stuff on the right-hand side and the left-hand side got small? Unfortunately, when you hold the control key down with the online version of Windows and you scroll back with that red button on your mouse, everything gets smaller. If we go forward, everything's going to get larger again. So that's something you might run into. So let's hold our control key. Let's just pick this up, bring it over. Let's go /20, enter. Now you've got a few that are inside our diving board, which we're not gonna need. Let's just erase those. Okay. I'm gonna erase this one too, and you'll see why in a bit. Okay, now we've got that. I'm going to edit this component and go to edit components. I'm going to go here to here. And if I'm lucky, which I am, it didn't intrude on the diving board. Now, if your spacing doesn't work out like mine, and it does, you might have to make this one post unique and then just edit that unique component. So let's zoom on in. And let's go over here, and we're going to pick the follow me option. Click. Okay, let's just follow that. Okay. Now it has thickness. Okay. Now what we're going to do is we're going to import some furniture. Let's go to the 3D warehouse. Let's get ourselves a bed. Click. Let's throw the bed on there. On face. Okay. Now I want that bed against this wall. So I'm going to move it over, using my move option, grab it by one of the bottom corners, and I'm going to put it right there on edge. Okay, so let's import a couch. Couch or sofa? Okay, there's a couch. Well, let's throw our couch here. Okay. And you're going to need a dresser. Got to put your clothes away somewhere. Okay. Okay. Now, if you end up with something that you want to rotate, just go over here to the drop-down menu. Actually, nope. Go over to the move menu. My apologies. And put this rotator on the very top. Click once. Go straight out. It's green. That signifies straight. And let's rotate it over here. Turns red. If you look on the bottom right hand corner, we've rotated it 90 degrees. And there you go. Perfect rotation. We're going to go back. We're going to select move. And let's just move this over. Like so. Perfect. Let's do a quick check. Make sure nothing's going through the floor like our dresser is. If it is, let's select our move option. Grab that bottom corner, bring it up so it says on face. Perfect. Now, I'm not going to do it for the this example, but there's an expectation that there's additional furniture down here. The example gives some of the things that you can put in there. Pinball machines, pool tables, etc., etc. That's it for this tutorial for assignment 3.